Hi, folks. I'm Steve Adubato. This is a very special event. Yes, it's virtual, but no less special. This is the 25th Russ Berry Making a Difference Award ceremony. Now, listen, of course, because of COVID-19, we can't be together this year. Cross our fingers, next year we will. But this year, we're doing this virtually. 1997 was the first year that the Russ Berry Award started. Let's go to 2021. So that's 25 years. Get these numbers. These numbers are powerful. These statistics are staggering in a good way. Over 3,800 unsung heroes have been nominated. 380 individuals have been honored from every corner of the state, and $3.75 million have been awarded in these presentations and these award ceremonies that, by the way, I've been honored to have been moderating and hosting from the beginning. Now, some of the nominations came in before the pandemic. Some of them came in after the pandemic, but all of the nominees, all of those who we recognize in this virtual event, are making a huge, huge difference in their communities. Let's take a look.
Dionisio Cucuta Jr., also known as Chef Dion, a Marine veteran from Teaneck, is described as an irreplaceable asset to his community. Recognizing that the COVID-19 pandemic created devastating food insecurity for many vulnerable residents in Bergen County, Chef Dion jumped into action. Drawing on his culinary background, he created Hot Wheels, hot dinners prepared from scratch for families at Bergen Family Center. He has since created Table to Table Tuesday, a raw food distribution program donated by Table to Table Food Rescue Organization. Chef Dion has also been a longtime mentor to young people through the Disabled Combat Veterans Youth Program and Englewood's Culinary Cadets Program.
In 1977, I went into the Marine Corps, enlisted, and that's where I received my trade, which is cooking. I spent 3 years on as a drill instructor, and then I decided that I had enough of the Marine Corps. I was young and I got out. And then I stuck with the food service industry. 15 years ago, I was diagnosed with a lot of conditions due to my military injuries, and it resulted in me retiring because I just couldn't do it any longer. And I was, mentoring youth, being a football coach here in Englewood, and next thing I know, I got this small nonprofit. I meet so many different people in different communities I'm involved in, and we share, our likes. I get so many phone calls that folks have lost their jobs or their businesses have diminished and declined. So that gave me a huge indication, knowing that folks are losing their jobs because as a result of the pandemic, knowing they got families. It's time for me to step it up and go into second gear and get the food. We stack the bags up and with different kits in them and extra vegetables, just in the bags. But as you'll notice, when the cars come up, they'll receive additional tomatoes, cucumbers, carrots that are in white bags. We don't know what we're receiving till we get it. And that's the fun part about it, because then we can get creative. Here we are, 58 weeks later. I figure we'll do about 3,500 families, and we're pushing at 2 million meals already since last year. I have an amazing team. They really care, and they'll remind me of everything, because I'll forget who I am as I'm moving and navigating, because I'm hands-on. I just can't sit back and just watch my team work, and I just stand there. It's a Marine Corps tradition, you lead by example. You're the first one here, and you're the last to go. I know that people really are in need. Just to see my team and just to feel the love that we're giving to those that can't even love themselves at this point because of the confusion, I know it makes a difference. And that's all I want to do, is make a difference and impact on people's lives.